What's up, everybody? It's your boy Cato back again with another video. On today's video, we're actually going to be riding with one of my boys here, and he actually has a CBR 600 double R, so it's pretty cool. It's going to be a lot of fun. So the subject of today's video is what happened to my BRZ. All right, so great question, even though nobody asked it because I have like 2 subscribers. So what happened to my BRZ is a few things. So at first I really liked the car, it was pretty good, and then I kept driving and everything, and I started losing like passion for driving. I couldn't tell if it was just the car or anything, but I know there's a good amount of rev hang in these newer gen BRZ and 86. Well, I don't know about the 86. I'm sure they're the same exact car though, but there's a good amount of rev hang. I absolutely hate rev hang, but I was like, forget about it, I don't mind, I'll deal with it. So I dealt with it, and like, don't get me wrong, it's a great car. This is strictly my opinion, so don't quote me on this, all right? But I'm sure not everybody has the same opinion. That's why we, you know, live in this world. Everybody has their own opinion. But pretty much what happened is one time I was going for a ride, some spirited driving, obviously, and after the drive, I had alright, sorry about that. But after the drive, I started to smell like a burning smell, like almost like metal on metal, like burning. Not clutch, but like a burning smell. And I was wondering, I was like, okay, it only had like 8,000 miles at the time, so I was like, okay, maybe it's nothing. So I kind of just left it overnight. Usually some smells go away after that. Unfortunately, that smell didn't end up going away the next day. So I was like, okay, maybe it's, you know, still like, I mean, I know it's weird to say, but this is, I'm looking for positivity. So I'm like, okay, maybe it's still like, you know, it's still a new car, there's gonna be some weird smells within everything. So I was like, okay, whatever. So I kind of just left it, and then a week later, like, I was like, man, this smell is still here. What is this smell? So I was like, I wanted to make an appointment with the dealership. So I made an appointment and everything, and as I got there, they were unfortunately, they were trying to make me like pay like the diagnostic fee and everything, which I understand. They have to check in everything. I used to be a service advisor as well, so like I get it. But like usually when it's this low of miles, you know you can hook someone up, you know, especially if it's a newer bike and all, newer car and all. But unfortunately, they did not help me out. So I just ended up canceling it. I took it to one of my friends that's a mechanic. He says he thinks the differential has some damage to it because the smell was coming straight from the differential. And right then and there, I was like, stop. I don't want to deal with this. I'm not even liking the car that much. So I was like, okay, forget about it. So then I just ended up selling it, and actually on the next video I will actually show you what car I did get, which you guys probably already seen. I made a short on there, and you guys will probably see it on there already, but I'll do a review. I've already done some mods. Unfortunately, I was away from YouTube, so I already did some mods ahead of time. So yeah, but anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this ride. I'm not gonna be talking too much, but it's mostly just gonna be recording. So enjoy it and have a good time. right, hit this curve.
My mic was dead, and also this was the last clip that I filmed before my camera died. Other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget, spread love, not hate. Peace out.